मॉर्निंग टू ऑल, वेरी हार्टी वेलकम टू माय चैनल। इन द प्रीवियस क्लास वी हैड सीन हाउ टू परफॉर्म रीड ऑपरेशन एज वेल एज राइट ऑपरेशन इन अ बाइनरी फाइल कंटेनिंग इंडिविजुअल डिक्शनरी ऑब्जेक्ट्स। सो टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू सी सम अदर फंक्शंस, दैट इज लुकअप, अपडेट एंड डिलीशन। सो लेट्स मूव ऑन। So these were the various operations which we had to perform on the file. So we are going to see lookup today, update and deletion. So we'll see what is lookup. Lookup means basically it is for searching. This doesn't work very properly, so I'm just going to tell you here. So lookup is basically for searching for a record, and your Updation is modification and deletion is removal of a record. So we are going to see these options over here. So let's start. So first we will start with lookup. So we will just provide here def lookup, and lookup we will be performing based on employee name or employee code. So it's up to you. So let us choose the simple one for the time being, that is eco, employee code. So again we are going to create an empty dictionary emp, and we will first seek the file pointer to the beginning of the file so that it starts reading from the beginning. Every time you perform any read operation, you should make sure that you seek the file pointer at the beginning, because for writing we don't need to seek the file pointer at the beginning. Now after doing this, it has to be we'll use the try block while true. Now we have to read individual objects from the file, so for that we will be first reading this, that is emp equals pickle dot load file. So with the help of this we will be able to load pickle dot load file. We will be able to read one dictionary object containing employee record in emp, and we can easily print the value also. We can print that, but we would be printing only after we have searched. So now we will be typing here if emp emp code, if it is equal to the e code entered by the user, then it means that the record has been found. So we are going to type here print emp, and we are going to break, and if it is not found, that is if we have an EOF error, that is it's not displayed, so we will simply print here. So we will print here record doesn't exist. So we will just print here record doesn't exist in case the record is not there in the file. So here also we will just type emp.clear in case everything is done, and we'll just call this lookup function here. So for this, firstly we need to ask employee code from the user. Enter the employee code and call the lookup function and pass e code to it. So let's just try it out. Employee code E101. So yes, it is being displayed. Once again I will call this using E102, and yes, it is being displayed successfully. Now based on this, next is updation. So we will be seeing updation over here. So let's create a function for this, update emp, And for this also, we will be asking for employee code from the user. And we have to remember that you will not give the user any privilege to update your employee code. Now, what is the technique which we are going to follow over here? Students, we know that in the disk file, everything is in the form of a dictionary. That is, we have separate dictionary objects. So we have separate dictionary objects over here. So how will we be doing it? We would be creating a list of dictionary objects. In the previously you had seen list of lists, so this time it would be list of dictionary objects, where each dictionary object will be one list item. So here also we will follow the same step. Firstly, read all the dictionary objects into this outer list. Then provide the user an update menu, that is, allow the user to update everything except the employee code. And once the user is satisfied, change the record. Suppose we want to update this record, so change this dictionary object with the updated dictionary object. And then dump this entire list object to the file. So this is the technique which we are going to follow. So this would take a while. So I would like you all to be a little patient over here. So I'm going to move on to this. Right. So first thing, create an empty dictionary object over here. Create a list object, employees. So for this empty dictionary object, I'm going to use record, and employees would be the list object to store all the employees. Store all employee records. Whereas this record function, this record is going to store only one employee record as dictionary object. So after this, we are going to read the data from the file. So file.seek 0 within the try block while true, and let us read one record. So record equals pickle.load file, and add this to the employee list. So employees.append record. So we will append it to the record. So first thing, we have to do this. Now over here, we are going to complete this, and when EOF error is raised, at that time we have to do nothing but just type pass. So this part was to store all the employee records. Next, we are going to search for the record. So for searching for the record, we would be copying this code over here. So I will just copy this code. Later on, I will also tell you how to use the lookup function for performing this. So we will be doing that a little later. Right now, we will stick to this. So searching for a record. So for searching for a record, we can, instead of using EMP, we can use record. Again, seek. We don't need the seek function over here because we have already saved everything. Okay, fine. We don't need all this because we have already saved everything in the outer list object called employee. So we will now just be accessing that list object to perform a lookup. So for record in employees, now what is record? Record is an individual dictionary object. So that dictionary object contains all this data, that is emp code, emp name, dept, desic, salary. So we are going to concentrate mainly on the employee code. Now, because employee code is a key, so we can perform the operation in this way. If record emp code, if it is equal to e code which is entered by the user, that means match is found. So we are going to create an empty matched record mrec, which will be an empty dictionary object, and or instead of that we can also set it as none, because when we simply assign a dictionary object to mrec, it will be already populated. And mrec no, that is match record number, also we will set it as none. So if a match is found, that means mrec should be equal to record, and mrec no should be equal to the record number. So for that we will add an index value over here, and we'll use the enumerate function, and we will just type here I, and once this is done we can just press break. So this will help us to search for the record. So now if mrec, that is if mrec contains valid data, the meaning of this statement is if mrec contains valid data or valid record, so then perform all the operation, then only we have to give the user the chance to update everything. So here also we will use while true, because we will be providing a menu to the user. Print update employee record. So quickly print . So we are just going to provide the values here. The first one is going to be employee code. No, sorry, employee name. The second one will be department. Third one will be designation, and then we have salary. So these four things only we will allow the user to enter. Now we will ask for choice. Enter your choice. So if choice is one, that means user can update employee name. So for this also, again I'll just create the structure quickly. Update department. Update designation. Update salary. So all these things, and if anything else is entered, then break, because our fourth option to the user will be to break. Sorry, fifth option. So user can go back. Now for the first one, new ename. So for new ename, let us ask it from the user, enter the employee name, enter the new employee name. And now what we are going to do is mrec was the dictionary where which dictionary object which contained our matched record. So within that, within ename, और एम्प नेम, आई फर्स्ट चेक व्हाट वाज द नेम व्हिच आई प्रोवाइडेड, की इट वाज एम्प नेम. ओके, सो एम्प नेम इक्वल्स न्यू ई नेम. सिमिलरली फॉर द अदर्स ऑल्सो, न्यू dept input enter the new department and mrec dept will be equal to new dept. New desic equals input enter the new designation mrec new desic and finally salary. Enter the new salary. Mrec salary equals new salary. So let's first check the keys whether we have used. Yes, desig and salary. Fine. So we have asked for all the values. So at the end of this loop, mrec would be an updated record which we just have to change in our main student database. Sorry, employee database. So now employees is the list which contains all my dictionary objects. Employees is, it contains all the dictionary objects as you can see here. So right now mrec is the dictionary object which contains updated values, and mrecno, it contains this number, that is index number of the outer list. So what we can do is, if I change this, that is if I write employees mrecno equals mrec, then that will replace this object with this updated object, and at the end we can dump this entire list object to the file. So for doing that, we are going to check it over here. We'll just keep track of the various blocks. So all this is happening within mrec only. If mrec, yes, I was just checking whether I am using the correct indentation or not. So now once this is done, that is once we come out of the while loop, we have to now change the or replace the record in employee list. So what we are going to do, employees is the list, mrecno is the index number, and we will be replacing it with mrec. So now this entire employee list has been updated, which we can easily dump back to the file. So for doing that, dump the employee list to disk file. So we will again be using a loop over here. So for record in employees, just a sec. We have to do something over here. That is, right now your database, your file contains these values. So we have to first remove all these content. Earlier what we were doing is we were closing the file and then again opening it using the write mode. But this time we are using only one file mode. So we are going to first seek the file pointer wherever it is in the file to the beginning of the file. And then we will use a function called truncate function, which would delete all the content of the file, but it will not delete my file. So for this purpose, I'm just going to type here file dot seek 0, then file dot truncate. So this will delete all previous file content. And now we can write peacefully in the file. So how we are going to do it? For record in employees, we are going to use pickle.dump record. So this will dump everything, and then finally I will type here file.flush, which will forcefully write or save all the content back to the file. And finally we will give a message record updated successfully. And if this is not so, that is if mrec, we have to keep track of this, if mrec doesn't contain any valid record, that is if there is none in mrec. So in that case, you have to print record not found. That's it. And if the record is not found, there is no point in updating anything. So once this is done, let us check whether it is correct or not. So we are going to ask for the employee code from the user, and we will call this function, that is updateM. I'm going to copy this from here, and here I'm going to paste it. UpdateM equal. Let's run the program. First, we will display all the employees. So there are only two employees. Let us try to insert a few more employees over here. So we'll at least five employees we should have. So let's display all the employee records. So yes, we have some. I missed on employee E104. So it doesn't matter. Now we will be going to the fourth option, that is update, and let us update the record of Anand Verma. So E105. Okay, so there is some problem with this. We are not okay. Now the problem was we did not display the record. So let us, we'll do that also. So right now I'm going to just go back, and here firstly I'll run it and check whether it's working fine or not. Okay, all the data has been gone. Okay, fine. So let me first add some records to the file. There was some problem in the code because of which the file was truncated, but it didn't get updated. So we are just going to add some records to the file quickly. At least five records we should have. So yes, all the records are there. So we will just exit the program and we'll go back to our program. And here in update, we are going to first display the record. So print MREC. This is the record which is found. E103. So this is the record of Shefali Rao, E103. And let us try to change the department. So I will be choosing a new department and let that department be marketing. And I'll be also giving a salary raise to her. So new salary would be some 26,000. And that's all. Okay, there is some problem. Dump missing required file argument, that is file. So as usual, all our previous content might have got deleted from the file, which we will be again entering. So here dump is missing file object. So unfortunately, truncate has already been executed. So we would have to enter the records once again. So I'll be back once I enter some records. You can see I have inserted 5 records and now I would be updating the record of Jagat Ram. And it looks like he is a poor person, so we are going to give him a salary raise. So 103 is the employee code of Jagat Ram. And let us first change his designation. And let his designation be team leader. And let me give him a salary raise to 15,000. And then press back. And let us check. So Jagat Ram is a team leader, as you can see it over here. He's a team leader and his salary has also updated to 15,000. So you can see that easily we have been able to update the records. Now, next is deletion. So in deletion also, we will follow the same method. Only difference is instead of changing the record, we are only going to remove it from the outer list object. So everything would be the same. So I'm just going to copy everything which is there in update. So in fact, I'll copy this entire update function and we would make changes in this function itself. So here it is, and let's change it to delete M. So here we don't need to save the record anywhere. So we are going to remove this. Okay, so record has to be added. Okay, no need to remove it because we are going to add it to record over here. Coming down, we don't need to save the record anywhere. We can simply just save the record number, that is the index. So if a match is found, then this is not needed. Only thing, we can print the record, and for that we will be using it this way, print record, and come down, if MRECNO, that is if the, now all this is not required because we are not going to update anything over here. So we will simply remove all this. It's better that we do it separately. So once we have searched for the record, once we got the record number, we are going to delete it. So now delete the record or matched record from employees list. So delete it from the employees list. So for that we will type employees MRECNO, and we can use the del function for doing this. Delete employees MRECNO. So this will remove that record from the list itself, and now we can easily write the content to the disk file. So dump the updated employee list to disk file. So for this, again file.seek0, file.truncate, that is remove all the contents of the file, and now we will be for record in employees, pickle.dump record, comma file object, and finally file.flush. So this will write everything back to the file, and then we will check. Now if suppose the record is not there, so there is no meaning in doing all this, so for this we would be adding a code if mrecno. Only if there is valid data in matched record number, only then we need to perform all these steps, and we will also provide a message, record deleted successfully. Else we will simply print record doesn't exist. Okay, so we will simply print that record doesn't exist. So now we will be calling this function, that is delete m over here, which is our last case, and we are also going to call ask for employee code from the user. So let's delete the record of Shefali Rao. So we are going to press 5 as the choice, employee code 104. So record deleted successfully. Let us check. Yes, Shefali Rao's record has not been deleted. Instead, we got the last record deleted. So we have to check out what is the problem with the code. Suppose I give this 1E104. Yes, now it has, maybe I entered something wrong earlier. It was, I had entered 5E104 only I had entered. It had printed that, but then it Yes, I had entered 105. Entered the choice 5 and I had entered 105, which deleted S valence record. It's working fine. It's right. There's no problem in this. So this is how we delete records from the file. So in today's lecture, we have seen how to perform lookup, update, and deletion from our file, and this time the file contains individual dictionary objects. So with dictionary objects it is very easy to work, because we have to match the keys with the values, so it's very easy. So you can also explore it with tuples or any other objects like strings and see it for yourself. So we conclude today's class over here.